Today is the first day of the 10th month on our Creator's restored calendar. It is December 14th on the calendar that Satan gave his disciples or his children to use. It is on this day that Noah was able to see the tops of the mountains. This is recorded in Genesis chapter 8, verse 5, and the waters continued to decrease. This is symbolic of the days of Tehillah's wrath continuing to decrease in his end time timeline until the 10th month. In the 10th month, on the first day of the month, the tops of the mountains were seen. The reference to the mountains is a reference to the heads of the nations. Yahweh has revealed that World War III will be let loose in the 30 days that follow today. He has been rising up five nations that will soon come against the scattered descendants of Israel. His Ezekiel chapter 4 prophecy, along with other prophecies that have been fulfilled during his end time timeline, have testified that many of the prophecies that are for Jerusalem and Judah in the last days are referring to the United States, the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel. His prophecy for Yeshua and Zerubbabel that was given for the last days tells us in Haggai chapter 2, "Speak to Zerubbabel, the head of Judah, saying, I will shake the heavens and the earth. I will overthrow the thrones of kingdoms, and I will destroy the powers of the kingdoms of the heathen. And I will overthrow their chariots, and those that ride in them, and their horses, and their riders will be cast down, each man by his brethren's sword. In that day, saith Yahweh of hosts, I will bring Zerubbabel, my servant, the son of Shealtiel, saith Yahweh, and I will put upon him a signature ring, because I have chosen him, saith Yahweh of hosts. The signature ring that he has sent me to you with is Isaiah 55:11. Isaiah 55:11 testifies to why he gave his word to us, why it came down to us from heaven. He gave us his word to teach us to think like he thinks and to walk with him to become as he is. So our thoughts become as his thoughts are. He has woven the numbers 55 and 11 throughout his end time timeline. It was 550 days ago today that he led me to scatter the last one-third of my hair into the wind per his Ezekiel chapter 5 prophecy. This was done 7 days prior to his restored Feast of First Fruits, which was the day that his only begotten son returned like a thief in the night to harvest his father's first fruits. 7 days ago today was the 24th day of the ninth month. It was on the 24th day of the ninth month that the Most High gave this prophecy to his servant Haggai. You should marvel at the intricate detail that our Creator has woven into his word and into his end time timeline. Instead, most of you scoff and mock. Today we are 450 days from last year's Memorial of Acclamations that most of you erroneously call the Feast of Trumpets. Yahweh has sent me in the similitude of the prophecies that are recorded in his word with an emphasis on a similitude of the prophecies of his servant Elijah. There were 450 prophets of Baal that Elijah commanded to be killed back then. The first day of the 10th month was also the day that the remnant of Judah and Benjamin that returned to Jerusalem after the 70-year captivity gathered together to discuss putting away their strange wives. 70 days ago today was the last day of the Feast of Temporary Dwellings on the Most High's restored calendar. Yahweh's word testifies that he is going to empower five nations to come against you. 5 days from today is the fifth day of the 10th month. His word tells us in Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 21, and it came to pass in the 12th year of our captivity, in the 10th month, in the fifth day of the month, that one that had escaped out of Jerusalem came to me, saying, the city is smitten. If we're willing, I will expand on this prophecy that was given for this end time Son of Man in another video. Notice that this prophecy is for one that had escaped. Yahweh led me to dig out from Jerusalem at the beginning of his 3.5-year witness back in 2010 per his Ezekiel chapter 12 prophecy. Notice this verse tells us in the 12th year. Like I said, you should marvel at the intricate detail that he has woven into this. The United States, along with the rest of the scattered descendants of Israel, will be smitten in the coming 30 days. There might be other small nations that join in with these five nations, but there will be five primary nations involved in the destruction of the United States. And other prophecies show that the physical nation of Israel and the city of Jerusalem will not be left out of this. It is just that the physical nation of Israel and Jerusalem will not be utterly destroyed like the United States will be. In Hosea chapter 5, verse 7, they, referring to the descendants of Israel and specifically separating out Judah and Ephraim in the preceding verses, thus putting an emphasis on those whom he's gathered into the west at this time, per his Ezekiel chapter 4 prophecy, and me lying on my right side and facing the west. They have transgressed against Yahweh, and they have brought forth children that are strangers to me. Now in a month I will devour them amongst their portion. And he's going to, in the 10th month of this year, you have brought forth strange wives to the Most High. Speaking of Zerubbabel and referring to the tops of the mountains that were seen on the first day of the 10th month during the days of Noah, we are told, then the angel answered and spoke to me, saying, this is Yahweh's word that is upon Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith Yahweh of hosts. Who are you, great mountain? Before Zerubbabel's face you will become a plain. You'll be flattened. And he will bring forth the headstone, shouting favor for favor to him. The great mountain here is a reference to the tops of the mountains being seen in the days of Noah. Yeshua said it will be as it was in the days of Noah. Yet another parallel to the, I don't know how many that Yahweh has woven into his end time timeline. The headstone that this verse is referring to is our Messiah Yeshua, the word of Elohim. It's a name he was given. Yahweh Elohim has given his word upon his servant Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel means one who flows out from or escapes from the captivity of mystery Babylon. The Most High has manifested his prophecies to us for these past nearly 3.5 years in a phenomenal way that has testified to his word and to why he is sending his wrath and to whom he is going to send a double portion of it upon. He has sent me to the scattered descendants of Israel to tell you how to receive the favor of the atoning sacrifice substitution that he set up through his son's shed blood. Favor for favor. Turn from your rebellion to the Most High and return to him through that which he has restored, or else prepare to be smitten. Thus says Zerubbabel, the one whom that Yahweh Elohim has appointed to be head of Judah at this time. Thus saith the testimony of Yahweh Elohim's word.